Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. This is Crazy Kitsune Gaming with another fun, exciting, chilling, calm episode of Fuga, Melodies of Steel. Now then, despite how absolutely chaotic last episode was, we're gonna be having a bit more of a chill episode today, as we have another village. Although first, we are going to look at the new Berman report we've gotten. Good God. Oh yeah, new characters too. Yeah! Almost forgot about that. So then, what is their description saying? Race? So this is Chick Month Blank. Such a strange name. Her race is Kaninu, gender female, and 6 years old. Hack's twin sister, surprisingly caring for her age. She follows Hack on his prankstering antics, and usually stops him from going overboard. And also Hack. So again, Kaninu, he is male though, and also 6 years old. Chick's twin brother. He is a fearless, naughty boy who loves pulling pranks. He and Chick found their helmets together on the battlefield. Oh, that's nice and sweet. And also, there are two others we came across. Yes, Stalin and Bam. So race, Kaninu, gender, male, and age, 84 years old. Viewing war as a game, he gets results through cruel and cunning schemes. General Bam is his rival. Speaking of whom? So, this is Von Bam. Yeah, it's very interesting family names. Von Stalin and Von Bam. Anyway, his race is Kaninu, he's male, and his age is 87 years old. An old general who views war as a game and attempts to achieve success through brute force. The soldiers under his command are nothing more than pawns. General Stalin is his rival. Yeah, they were very interesting characters. We won't really see them again for the entirety of the game, but they were a fun boss fight. Albeit a bit chaotic, I also realized I forgot to use my link attacks at all during the boss fight. Very, very good technique that definitely benefits you. Yeah, don't ever use your link attacks. That doesn't get you anywhere. Yeah. Got that one from Bad Advice Is Us. Alright then. Pretzel's private journal free. The siege of Parisia is advancing as scheduled. The Gasco army concentrated their forces in the capital, which made it impossible to protect their remote regions. Everything was proceeding as expected, but I absolutely cannot accept the remote areas are at the mercy of those two old generals. It was like a sick game to cause more casualties than necessary among non-combatant civilians who had no power to resist. And I keep complaining about their way of doing things, but they are old and hard of hearing now. To finish this battle, I'll have to keep a close watch on General Bam and General Stalin, and make sure they stay out of the front lines. I must suppress their rage, if only to aid the reconstruction after the war. Yeah, Pretzel was honestly quite a nice guy. Kinda sad that he was pretty much the first to die. Well, 10th to die. Speaking of which, what even is our kill count now? By the way, ignore the playtime, that's just cause I spend quite a bit of time preparing and rehearsing before I actually record, so it's kind of counting up despite that not actually being the real time that we've been going. At least, I don't have 13 hours worth of episodes yet. Although, with how long this game is, I'll get there eventually. But yeah, what is our kill count? Oh, 83! Oh, 83 people who've lost their lives to us. Oh my. Oh, it was like 30 before last episode. Oh, that's ridiculous. Yep, the game has officially started now. Now, with that in mind, we need to do the classic. All these people are going to be nice, so quick, everybody, spread out. Take advantage of their kindness. So, Mordell Gate. The Berman strength is the real deal, but Gasso seems to be handling it as best they can. Even strong armies have their weaknesses. If the Gasco army focuses on that, we might have a chance. Thank you for giving me a great energy cell, considering I used so many resources last episode. That was so chaotic. Alright then, Tabor Garden. The Burmen are attacking and looting villages, occupying others. It might not be safe here. I'd better gather up my things and prepare to escape. Here, you've got no more use for this. Okay, a great repair kit. Thank you. And now, champ. I'm not even going to try to pronounce the rest of that. Champ that square. That's its official name. You reading The Adventures of Secretary? I can't stand Professor Burry. Oh, well, I wouldn't know. You can't either, right? He annoyed me in the last episode, too. What? You haven't read it yet? Then here, read this. Thank you. Not actually going to read it, but thank you. And mark it. Not really going to mess with it, but let's at least look. Let's do some window shopping. So yeah, fun fact, all of the different ammos you can get, because I realized we actually used one last episode, I didn't really explain it a whole lot. These ammos basically let you apply a certain effect to an enemy without having to use SP. So ammo can be good to get, although sadly, because we have a money system, we can't buy ammo outright. All we can do is trade different ammos for other ammos. Kind of unfortunate. Oh wait, peace candy. Relieves depression. Oh, I didn't even know this was a thing in this game. I thought this was only something in Fuga 2. Or at least it only drops from enemies in Fuga 2. So yeah, 3 energy cells and greater energy cell gives you peace candy. That's cool. Especially since we don't really have abilities that get rid of it. Wow, yeah, I didn't know that. Yeah, I don't think peace candy drops from enemies. I could be wrong on that. But that's really interesting. Did this come from an update? Because it's gotten some updates. I don't recall peace candy even being a thing. That's so weird. Mostly what I came to show off was the fact that if you want, you can trade 3 small repair kits for a great repair kit. Basically, the great repair kits give you more health in a shorter turn. Now, they don't give as much health. I think they only give about double the health of a normal repair kit. But because that's only happening, it's only taking one turn, it can be more effective if you really want to condense their usage to not take much time. Now as for this, I'm still not really ready to start trading anything out yet. We're still at a stage where everything has a certain use. Okay then. So we're now done with the village basically, but now we have a whole intermission to do. So let's continue the adventure. Alright then, Chapter 4, Serenade for the Doll. Wooded Regents, Province of Vizsla, Gasco Backcountry. Following the directions from Bam and Stalin, the children continued south toward the mining area where their families had presumably been taken. For crap's sake, this better be over soon. I hope they have something to eat. Thank you, Boron. You're such a classic. We still haven't found Mommy and Daddy?
In front of the children, whose hearts were filled with both hope and apprehension, appeared what they previously thought was an illusion.
You mustn't fight.
The figure of light sounded like a little girl. Who was she? Why didn't she want them to fight? The children wanted to know, but she only kept repeating the same words before disappearing. The girl's words shook their battle-hardened conviction to the core.
Do you think she's right? That we shouldn't fight? Perhaps we should wait for the Gasco army to come? Who knows how long that'll take.
With doubt seeping in from the girl's warning, whatever determination they once had had vanished while the enemy drew near. Remember, my children, I am always watching over you. Oh wow, here we are again with the great music. Oh, I could listen to this for a while. This is so soothing. Don't give in. Just a little longer, and you'll have your families back. Oh, it's gotta be a lot longer than just a little longer. That moment, the voice helped to calm their fears, giving them momentary solace with its words of encouragement. Alright then. So then, onward to the next intermission. So we'll do this intermission, then that'll be the end of the episode, giving us a nice, clean slate for when we actually go into battle. Oh yeah, and a child in battle has been injured or knocked out. I forgot about that. Battles will be seriously affected if you do not act. Let's use the dormitory and the Taranis. We've done this before. So then. Yeah, poor May. She just got absolutely demolished. Ooh, the task plant apples has been added. Okay. Now, before we do anything, workshop. Yes, upgrade that cannon, please. Thank you for helping, Kyle. Oh, and please don't fail the upgrade while you're at it. That would be nice. Upgrading was successful. Good, good. Now we do the same for the machine gun. Thank you for helping out, chick. And now, yep, okay. So that puts everything at least level 4. And I realize we're already to the point we need another upgrade. What does that take? Basic tools and blueprints. Okay. But then everything can go up to level 10, so that'll keep us covered for a while once that's done. Now then, poor May does need to be healed up in the dormitory. Iron scrap. What do we need to expand this thing? Oh, ooh, yeah, we need wool and pine wood. Along with feathers, but we've already got the feathers covered. Could I get those items before? No, because the wool will take a bit too long. Okay, so just go ahead, get May recovered and Chick rested. So that should take care of their injuries. Unless the game wants to pull out an absolute blinder. Which, thankfully, it doesn't appear it did. Good. But now we've already used like half of our action points. This could be a very short episode. Thank you, sleep mechanics. Alright then, all the way down here. Let's grab that, why not? Another silk line, good, good. So then, we can expand something here. Do I want to? It's the pen. It takes birch wood. And or the coop. Oh wait, no, the garden itself can be upgraded. Yeah, we have the potting soil and the rough tools. Sure. Because that means that all of the, what's the word I'm looking for? All of the food items will grow a bit faster and efficiently. We still need old lamps to just increase the amount of plots we have outright. And now, also, we can upgrade the pen or the coop. Let's go the pen, since I'm really low on the wool right now. So let's go ahead and do that. Perfect. So, pen's expanded. Good. Oh, and Hannah feels great. I want to expand the garden on the farm. I didn't even look at the notebook yet. Yeah. Socks wants to have some guy talk. Okay. And Malt wants to play with Cluckin on the farm. Oh, and Boron wanted to expand the coop. Oops. Sorry. Well, Hannah wanted to expand the garden, so we're kind of neutral-ish. So then, Moose Sheep, Cluckin, and we'll play with our new apples and potatoes. Because potatoes, just they deserve the love. Alright then. That should make people happy, right? Yep, everyone's happy. Everyone loves apples and potatoes being planted. Anyway, Let's go ahead and... What is it? May wants to talk to someone. Kyle wants to have guy talk. Kyle... Not Kyle. Socks. Why do I think everybody's Kyle? Well, honestly, speaking of which, I guess we could talk to Kyle for a moment. Wherever he is. Actually, no, let's go Malt. Malt is here. Are we doing the right thing? I mean, yeah. I mean, it's gonna end up with a lot of dead Burman, but, like, they attacked first. We're doing the right thing. And now let's switch to May, because she also wants to talk to someone. Anyone will do, but... Hey, Malta's right here, and Malta's kind of her brother, you know. She deserves to have some chatting with him. I can't stress out over this. I've got to be strong. Yes. Strong as in getting more affinity. Alright then. So, I'm satisfied with our notebook progress. Satisfied enough. Okay then. What do we really want to do with the last of our action points? I'm not entirely sure. Scrap fishing would be a good choice. But we could do an expedition. And I'm always up for an expedition. I realize it's mostly because I've been so used to playing Fuga 2. And in there, if you think the expeditions are good in that game, or in this game, the expeditions in Fuga 2 are insane, because in Fuga 2, everything is helpful. Even upgrade materials that you can't use anymore, because you can sell them. So I'm probably overselling how good the expeditions are just a tad bit, but... I don't know. They're fun to do, if nothing else. It's a nice break from, you know, doing the intermissions, constantly blowing things up. We recognize this setup, don't we? But yeah, just after the chaos of last episode, you know, it's just nice to have a bit of a break. Even if you can technically fail the break. Imagine failing having a break. I guess that would be like the equivalent of, you know, trying to sit down, get some rest, and then you just think of another thing that you need to do for the day. And then you just go ahead and do it, never getting any rest that you intended. That would be the real life equivalent, I'm pretty sure, of failing a break. Well, at least that's something that we haven't done. Expedition complete. We got everything, right? Yes, sir. Oh, yes, we did. And basically everyone leveled up except for May. What did May do? What would she do to not join the level up party? Oh, come on. Nah, you know, I'm scrap fishing with May. No, she deserved to get a level up. She should join in on the level up party. Come on. That's ridiculous. Malt, get out of the chair. We are leveling up. This is final. Unless this just doesn't give enough experience to levels up. And then, I'll go and cry about it. But it looks like I won't need to. Scrap fishing was successful. Alright then. Not as much as I would have liked, but okay. And yes, okay, good, we leveled up. Good. I would have tweeted my displeasure if I didn't get that level up. Okay then. Ah, it was a nice, quick, chill episode. Literally the exact opposite of what last episode was. So then, with that out of the way, consider liking and subscribing, especially subscribing. And I'll go ahead and see you in the next episode. Have a good day, everyone.